Welcome to Undisputed. We are live from Los Angeles. I'm Jenny Taft. Here with Skip Bayless, Shannon Sharpe. Good morning. How are we doing on this Friday?
Jenny, guys? How are you?
Good. Good morning. How are you today? You know, I brought a little piece of jewelry out. You know, Skip got to drive with last night.
You know what? I like that.
How did I miss
actually,
I like that?
Skip, you know, this is the first time I've actually worn you've ever seen me wear this ring. Because I feel a little guilty sometimes wearing it because I get to wear it, but so many other people were involved.
Huh.
But there are a lot of guys that's upset that they didn't go in the first round. But I didn't get this ring because I was drafted in the first round or the second round. I got this ring because once I got to a location, I showed up and showed out.
Uh-huh.
So it doesn't matter where you get drafted, guys. Wow. It only matters what you do once you get there.
So this show is all about you.
No, no, see, like there it. You go. See, I you always do that, Skip. You know
what? This is your day.
Jenny.
That was a great reminder.
Jenny.
Yeah.
You know what it means, Skip.
He's not playing tonight.
No, it's that time, though.
He's not playing.
It's that time.
Oh, I can't hit that.
I see that thing up close. Oh, my gosh. I thought that was a great reminder to a lot of people.
Yeah, you know what, Skip.
Well, whatever you think.
We've got a lot to get to, a ton of NFL draft talk today, so why wait? Let's get right to it.
Yep.
It was no surprise that Kyler Murray went number one overall, but the Giants shocked a lot of people by picking former Duke quarterback Daniel Jones with the sixth pick. Jones seems like the heir apparent to Eli Manning, but GM Dave Gettleman said yesterday he can see him sitting for 3 years like Aaron Rodgers did with Brett Favre.
What?
Ohio State quarterback Dwayne Haskins fell all the way to number 15 to the Redskins. It's no surprise that Haskins did not take the drop very well. Let's take a listen.
I'm more motivated now than ever. There's a bigger chip on my shoulder. Lead done messed up, and I'm just blessed by God, blessed by my family. I'm right down the street, so we're going to do it right this time, so it's crazy.
All right, Shannon, who made the better pick, Washington or New York?
I believe it was Washington, Skip, because they got the second quarterback, the second rated quarterback in the middle of the first round. And so I like this. I like the fit because if you look at what Washington does, Jay Gruden runs the West Coast offense. A lot of those principles, what they run at Ohio State, you throw the ball, a lot of shallow crosses, Skip, get the ball to the receivers and let them do the leg work.
Mm-hmm.
The ball doesn't spend a whole lot of time. Now, they will throw the ball down the field, but the objective in the West Coast is put the ball into your playmakers' hands, let them make plays.
Yep.
The Daniel Jones selection, Skip, for the Giants, what this tells me is that they had him rated so much higher than everyone else. Because if you look at it, Kyler Murray was going to be gone. Everybody knew Kyler Murray was going to be gone. So it came down to Haskins, it came down to Jones, Drew Lock, and Will Greer. They telling me that they had Daniel Jones so much more, so much higher rated than the other two because I believe they could, you believe, I believe, a lot of people believe they could have got Daniel Jones at 17.
Heck, I think they might have got him in the third round, but that's just me. Go ahead.
And so, Skip, so that tells me. Now, it's hard for me to criticize because Dave Gettleman talking about, well, we don't draft, you know, you don't want to get caught up drafted for need.
Yeah, well.
You took a quarterback with the sixth pick.
What do you say? You always get screwed when you do that.
Oh, you know, yeah.
Okay.
So with that, Skip, they needed a quarterback. I think everybody really thought they needed a quarterback.
Mm-hmm.
We just didn't think they're going to take a quarterback this high. It's hard to criticize them because, you know what? They had this guy rated that high. Skip, if I need a house, there's only a few on the market in the neighborhood. You're going to overpay. You're going to overpay, Skip. If you want to live in a particular neighborhood, there's two houses for sale. Hmm. You're going to overpay. You know that. You know how L.A. works, especially in this area.
Hmm.
They overpaid. I believe they overpaid, but they had to have a quarterback, and they valued him. So what am I supposed to do, Skip? If I need a car, okay, the Ferrari is gone. I got choices. I got a Ford. I got a Chevy Cobalt. I got this. Yeah, Skip, you're like, well, hold on. Everybody else, you know, I could get that car from, but no. I need a car now.
Hmm.
They needed a quarterback. They paid too much for him. But can you blame them if you need something overpaying for it?
Yes, I can.
You should be celebrating.
Tell me when it's my turn.
You should be happy. See, you want to pretend like you're upset, but you're loving this.
I saw upset? Your tweet last night.
Yeah.
Upset about what?
No, I'm saying you pretended like Giants made a big mistake, but secretly, you're clapping. You're doing that golf clap because, like, yeah, we got Dak, and they got Daniel Jones, and Washington got Haskins. Ooh, we good. But you got to worry about Philly.
Huh? I have no worry with Philly.
You need to worry about
that. They took an offensive lineman. I'm thinking, well, you can't really save Carson Wentz from himself.
Whatever.
You know, you can try to protect him, but he can't protect himself from himself, right?
Whatever.
Now, I am going to speak as a Cowboy fan. Thank you for teeing me up for that, Jenny, because I am the first to tell you I am not afraid of either of these two young quarterbacks in New York or Washington. In fact, I am very relieved by both picks.
You
if you told me they got Will Greer, I'd say, I'm in trouble. I told you, Will Greer, second best quarterback behind Kyler in this draft, and somebody is about to get a steal of the draft in Will Greer tonight in round, I don't know, two or three, somewhere in there, probably in round two.
I agree with you.
And I go so far as to tell you I welcome both of these choices by both of these teams because now both teams are going to be stuck with projects at quarterback who ultimately will frustrate and disappoint them. And these are long-term projects, both of them. And in fact, Gettleman made the joke about we could be on the Green Bay plan now, you know, the three-year plan. Well, good luck to you.
Because, he got Aaron Rodgers. Yeah. That's what he tried to say.
That's what he's saying. And I'm with you. Look, I'll give you Haskins was a much better choice than Daniel Jones. I give him a little more upside. I give him a little better shot than Daniel Jones. And I was impressed that Dan Snyder didn't overreact and trade up to get Dwayne Haskins, who was way overrated. Again, there's so much talk about him going sixth. Mm-hmm. At least Washington sat still and had him fall to them at 15. So I'm going to give you that much. Now back to Daniel Jones. This is by far the biggest reach of the night. This is potentially the biggest bust, the biggest swing and miss in this entire draft is poor Daniel Jones. And I feel for this kid because you know how the New York media is.
Yeah.
There's no way his talent, his ability to perform in the National Football League can measure up to the expectations that have now been created in New York City, Big Apple, New Jersey. It's just going to be Richter scale for this kid. Mm-hmm. And there's no way he's going to be able to live up to this. And to me, reaching for Daniel Jones at six was even a much bigger reach than Cleveland Furl at four. We're going to talk about him and the Raiders in just a moment.
Yeah.
But that, at least I can make some case there. Right. I can make no case here. And in fact, they obviously had a chance to draft Sam Darnold a year ago, and they took Saquon. And I am not the biggest Sam Darnold fan, but trust me, he's way, way, way better than Daniel Jones.
Yes.
So I watched Daniel Jones, I don't know, four or five times last year. And trust me on this, not once did I ever turn on a Duke game and think, oh, that's a potential first-round pick. I didn't even think of him as a potential NFL player. Seriously, I didn't. I mean, maybe in the back of my mind, I would think fifth, sixth round backup. Maybe. But come on. So Todd McShay had him ranked as the 59th best player. I respect Todd's big board. And
where did Mel? Mel had him?
I'm not sure where Mel had him, but I know Todd, I think Mel was a bigger fan because Mel did have the breaking news that it looked like the Giants were leaning there. I'm not sure what Mel actually thought of the pick, but he was the first to be out there with that. So let me just put this in perspective. Pat Shurmur is the Giants head coach. I don't think Pat Shurmur had anything to do with this decision. That's just me. This is a Dave Gettleman special. Pat Shurmur has a son named Kyle Shurmur who will probably get drafted in the sixth or seventh round. For the last 3 years, he was my quarterback at Vanderbilt University. Kyle Shurmur is pretty good. I will bet you right now, if you put Pat Shurmur on a lie detector, if you put him feet to fire, he would tell you his son's a little better than Daniel Jones because I could just show you. They're both about the same size, 6'4", 6'5", 220. Kyle weighs 230. But if you look at their numbers last year, Kyle was 24 touchdowns and 6 interceptions. Daniel Jones was 22-9. QBR for Kyle was 66. For Daniel Jones, 62. So just his numbers at Vanderbilt as the doormat of the SEC was better than this kid. And this kid's last real game, home game at Duke, they lost 59-7 to Wake Forest. So what's Gettleman banking on here? Well, it's all about David Cutcliffe.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
David Cutcliffe obviously was the coordinator for Peyton at Tennessee, and he was the head coach for Eli at Ole Miss. So has deep ties to the Manning family. But is this Daniel Manning we're talking about? Is he like the grandson of Archie?
Or
No, he's not. Is David Cutcliffe going to coach the Giants next year? I don't think so. I think it's Pat Shurmur.
You mentioned it in the end. What would have scared me, Skip, is that they lost at home 59-7 away.
Yeah.
There's no way. The sixth pick in the draft. at the quarterback position should lose that game to that team.
I got it.
Clemson,
got
it. If you say Clemson beating 59 nothing, Skip, I was like, okay. They did have three defensive linemen going to top 2017, but not.
So he did have a decent bowl game, but then the senior bowl was the key. And Gettleman said, I saw a star or whatever he said.
He said a pro quarterback.
I saw a pro quarterback. You better see more than just a pro quarterback.
Yeah.
So what happened at the